This video goes over irrational numbers. Before we begin, let's review very quickly. We start with all real numbers, which has two subsets, rational numbers and irrational numbers. Let's diagram all real numbers. Rational numbers are made up of natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers. Rational numbers can be perfect square roots. Rational numbers can be made into a fraction or a ratio. In decimal form, they end or they repeat. You can look at earlier videos in this series to get a more detailed explanation of rational numbers and each of its subsets. Now, any real number that cannot be defined as a rational number is an irrational number. To define irrational numbers, they are non-perfect square roots, cannot be expressed as a ratio, A over B, where B cannot be zero. In decimal form, irrational numbers never end and never repeat. Okay, let's go over each definition in detail. Rule number one, a non-perfect square root is irrational. You may be asking yourself, what in the world is a non-perfect square root? To understand non-perfect square roots, we have to look at a list of the perfect square roots. Here is a list of perfect square roots from 0 to 100. As we evaluate each perfect square root, notice that all the solutions are in yellow. These solutions are rational because they are natural numbers, whole numbers, integers. The solutions can be made into a fraction or a ratio. In decimal form, they end or they repeat. Here's a chart of all the square roots between 0 and 100. The perfect square roots are highlighted in yellow. The rest are non-perfect square roots. Let's pick the square root of 45 as an example. Now, by definition, the square root of 45, when evaluated, cannot be made into a fraction or ratio, and in decimal form, never ends and never repeats. This leads into rule number two. Irrational numbers cannot be expressed as a ratio, A over B, where B cannot be zero. This means that an irrational number cannot be made into a fraction. To expand on this explanation, we evaluate the square root of 45 to get the number 6.70820393249936 9, and it continues. Okay, this number by definition never ends and never repeats. In order for a number to be expressed as a fraction or a ratio, it has to either repeat or end in decimal form. Now, for every rule, there is an exception. If you have a scientific calculator that has a fraction function, it will put the square root of 45 into a fraction form. However, if you evaluate both numbers, you can see that it is not the same number. So you can come to an approximation. Yet by definition, an irrational number cannot be made into a fraction or ratio. Please take note of the symbols at the end of the numbers. This tells us that the number continues. This moves us into rule number three. In decimal form, irrational numbers never end and never repeat. We will use our example, the square root of 45. In decimal form, it never ends and it never repeats. You may be familiar with this symbol. It's called pi. Pi is called an irrational number that is known to never end and never repeat. Now, some of you may have seen pi expressed as a fraction. By definition, irrational numbers cannot be expressed as a ratio or fraction. However, there is an approximation exception. Let's evaluate pi and its fraction form. Notice that in the decimal form, They are not the same number. You can approximate and come close to the value of a specific irrational number, yet it is not the same number. If asked, irrational numbers cannot be made into a ratio or a fraction. However, you can come to an approximation of a number that is very close to the value of an irrational number that can be expressed as a fraction or ratio.